let us discuss this complex topic in a simpler term. I will try to explain it. So monkey brain is basically the state where your mind is defocused and it is hopping from one thought to another thought, and mostly without any alertness, or you are not aware of those thoughts, but the mind is hopping from past to present and future and all kinds of your hidden anxieties or whatever it is. It's not always anxiety, but it can be just some happy thoughts or whatever it is. And awareness is basically the opposite of that, or alertness, when your brain is focused onto some task or some specific chain of thoughts. So that is called awareness, or you are alert about or aware about your body sensations or your breath or something like that. So this was popularized by Buddhist scholars, and it reached into the hands of American so-called seekers or whatever, materialistic come seekers. So they wanted to have some so-called materialistic benefits, or for example, can I improve my productivity, or can get better health, and blah blah blah. So they were looking for some selling point, you know, commercial points. So that's all about American or Western seekers. They are seeking something for something immediate benefit. They want something right now, something for this body and mind. So originally this thing has come from Upanishads or Vedas, and Buddhists diluted it, and they superficially connected it to something which is of this body or mind, something which is right now. So then Westerners, they liked this, and then they understood it because it was highly diluted form of Sanatana Dharma. And so that's the reason that you see these days in all kinds of lectures and books, self-help books, over hyperness basically, or obsessiveness about this term awareness, which is not understood properly by Buddhist or American philosophers. But it has its own benefit. They say that, okay, you are aware of your body sensations, you do the body scans and blah blah blah. But as a scientist, one would naturally ask the evolutionary aspect, that something is there in our mind, how the mind functions actually scientifically, why the monkey brain, that state is there, if it is not that useful. There has to be some use. We are talking about materialistic aspects only, not about spiritual aspects. So if it is there, that means it is of some use. And so what is the use of that? So people say that, okay, that it's a natural state of energy conservation. So you can't be always in the alert state, that you are always thinking of some task, or it's a hyperness. I mean, you can try to do that, you will go mad. If you try to be alert all the time or aware all the time, a person will be declared as clinically sick, mentally sick. So the random thoughts are basically for energy conservation of brain, because alertness or awareness requires a lot of energy, energy basically in the brain. So when you stop your work, when you're sitting in front of your PC and you stop your work, so what does the computer does? It slows down the computer. It puts the hard disk onto the sleep mode, and then screensaver starts on the screen. So these are some of the tasks which brain also does. So why do we have sleep if we have so much of productivity in the daytime, in the wakefulness? So random monkey brain is as important as alertness. That's what I'm trying to say. There are the two sides. There is nothing good or bad. Because Westerners, they have to declare something good or other things as bad. That's what they are trained to do that. But in pure form, there's nothing good or bad. I mean, monkey brain is highly important for the normal brain function. It's highly, highly important for the normal brain function. It leads to the creativity, new ideas, and it is the resting space of the brain. I mean, you have to do that. I mean, you can't. It's like, you know, you need sleep. You can't be awake all the time. So brain has got, and sleep also, it has got three different kinds of modes. Sleep is not just the sleep, plain simple sleep. So brain has got its own states, and they are the product of millions of years of evolution. So they are because of some specific use. So don't get into those hyper alertness or awareness, which is a very complex topic. And in Indian core philosophy, there is less emphasis to that because of the obvious reason, because it's at a lower platform. So awareness is not the same as alertness. It is sold as the same. I mean, awareness is basically awareness about you being part of the entire universe. Awareness is not just about my breath or body. It's about entire multiple universes, actually multiverses. It's about each life form. So it's basically expansion rather than contraction. It's basically expanding your consciousness to. It's a formless. You cannot explain it in the world as per the Indian Sanatana Dharma, Hindu literatures. So how do you term it? That you go into devotion, for example, Krishna consciousness. It's explained that you see everywhere the presence of God, Krishna, everywhere. So when you start seeing that, you are expanding it. You are not narrow. So awareness is not the narrowness. It's basically expanding to the infinity. Awareness is basically infinity, taking you to the infinite level. So alertness is for yourself, actually. You are going somewhere inside, or whatever you call it.